Dear students, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor of Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvundi. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture series on the subject Engineering Thermodynamics. This is module number 8, Thermodynamic Relations. And this is lecture number 2 on the module 8, Thermodynamic Relations, part 2. So in the earlier lecture, we derived the Maxwell's equation, and now we use the Maxwell's equation for further discussion. And the topic for today's lecture is TDS equation, difference and ratio of heat capacities. So there are two heat capacities for gases. So one is CP, specific heat capacity at constant pressure, and CV, heat capacity at constant volume. We are going to derive the difference between heat capacities and ratio of heat capacities, that is CP minus CV and the CP by CV. And we derive the energy equation. And the learning outcome for the lecture, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to derive the first TDS equation, derive the second TDS equation, derive the difference between heat capacities, derive the ratio of heat capacities, and derive the energy equation. Out of the 5 derivations, from the exam point of view, the first 2 derivations are important. First TDS equation and the second TDS equation. And TDS equation. T is the temperature, D is change in entropy, TDS equation. And we take entropy is a function of temperature and volume. So dS is a function of temperature and volume. Then we differentiate this equation. dS equal to dou S by dou T at constant volume into dT. Plus dou S by dou V at constant temperature dV. Then multiply this equation with the temperature T. So the TdS equal to T into dou S by dou T at constant volume temperature dT plus T into dou S by dou V at constant temperature dV. And the heat capacity at the constant volume CV is given by the earlier discussion. CV equal to T into dou S by dou T at constant volume. So the second term is equal to CV. First term, dou S by dou T at constant volume is what the CV. And from the Maxwell's third equation, we write dou P by dou T at constant volume equal to dou S by dou V at constant temperature. So the two expressions we are going to implement in the TDS equation. So substituting in the TDS equation. So the original TDS equation, this is the equation what we derived earlier. The same thing is rewritten here. TDS equal to T into dou S by dou T at constant volume into dT plus T into dou S by dou V at constant temperature dV. The second term, dou S by dou V at constant temperature equal to dou P by dou T at constant volume. And the first term is CV. So substituting, so TDS equal to, this is CV into dT plus T into dou P by dou T at constant volume dV. So this is known as the first TDS equation. So you have to remember, there is no other go. You listen to the lecture, take the notes or hints, and write, derive on your own. Then only you can remember the derivation, TDS equation. And for the second TDS equation, if entropy is a function of temperature and pressure, and we write, if S is a function of temperature and pressure, the same logic we follow. dS differentiating, dS equal to dou S by dou T at constant pressure dT plus dou S by dou P at constant temperature dP, and multiplying this equation again by the temperature. So TdS equal to T into dou S by dou T at constant pressure dT plus T into dou S by dou P at constant temperature dP. And this is the second TdS equation. We are going to modify this equation by substituting 2 terms. So the heat capacity at constant pressure is given as T into dou S by dou T at constant pressure equal to Cp. So T into dou S by dou T at constant pressure equal to Cp. The first term is Cp. And from the Maxwell's fourth equation, dou V by dou T at constant pressure equal to minus of dou S by dou P at constant temperature. And substituting in the TDS equation, this is the original TDS equation, what we derived earlier. And substituting the terms, so this first term, T into dou S by dou T at constant pressure equal to Cp. And this dou S by dou P, actually the dou S by dou P equal to dou V by dou T. So minus sign is there. So minus So dou Cp dt minus T into dou V by dou T at constant pressure into dp. So this is the second TDS equation. So the derivation of two TDS equations are important for our examination. And difference in heat capacities. So the first and TDS equation, equating the first and TDS equation, TDS equal to Cp into dt minus of dou T by dou V by dou T at constant pressure dp equal to second TDS equation Cv into dt plus T into dou P by dou T at constant volume into dv. So there are from the second and the third term Cp minus Cv. So I take Cv to the next term, left hand side, Cp minus Cv into dt equal to, I take this term to the right hand side. So T into dou P by dou T at constant volume dv plus dou T into dou V by dou T at constant pressure dp. And dt, so this term dt equal to taking the Cp to the other side. So T into dou P by dou T at constant volume divided by Cp minus Cv into dv plus T into dou V by dou T at constant pressure divided by Cp minus Cv into dp equal to, this is the equation number 1. So simple three steps. So the first TDS equation, second TDS equation, the equating these two, rearrange the term. Finally, we get a term for dt equal to this value. Now we take temperature is a function of volume and pressure. So dt equal to dou T by dou V at constant pressure dv plus dou T by dou P at constant pressure dp. And we consider this as equation number 2. Now comparing the equation number 1 and 2 and this equation. So the first dv term. So we have a dv term here. This is the dv term. So this comparison will give dou T by actually T into dou P by dou T at constant volume divided by Cp minus Cv equal to dou T by dou V at constant pressure. This is the coefficient of dv, and T into dou V by dou T at constant pressure divided by Cp minus Cv equal to dou T by dou P at constant volume. This is the coefficient of dp. So these are the two terms, and both equations gives Cp minus Cv equal to, so the, from actually this is the equation number 1. So we rearrange Cp minus Cv equal to, you look at the equation here, T into dou P by dou T at constant volume divided by dou T by dou V at constant pressure, or T into dou V by dou T at constant pressure divided by dou T by dou P at constant volume. So both the equations gives T equal to Cp minus Cv equal to T into dou P by dou T at constant volume into dou V by dou T at constant pressure. We have from the third theorem in terms of thermodynamic properties, dou P by dou T at constant volume into dou T by dou V at constant pressure into dou V by dou P at constant temperature equal to minus 1. I keep the first term to the left side, other two terms are taken to the right side. So minus 1 divided by these two terms, dou T by dou V at constant pressure, dou V by dou P at constant temperature equal to. So I take the term to the numerator. So the reciprocal, it will be appearing in terms of reciprocal, minus of dou T by dou V becomes dou V by dou T at constant pressure, and dou V by dou P becomes dou P by dou V at constant temperature. Now substituting in the value of C, this equation. Substituting here, dou V by dou T at constant pressure and dou P by dou T at constant volume. So substituting for dou P by dou T at constant volume is equal to this term. So this will become, look at here, dou P by dou T at constant volume. Here dou P by dou T at constant volume, we substitute for here. So this will become dou V by dou T at constant pressure square into dou P by dou V at constant temperature. So Cp minus Cv equal to T into minus of T into dou V by dou T at constant pressure whole square into dou P by dou V at constant temperature. So this is the original equation. This is from the third theorem, and the rearranging and substituting for dou P by dou T in this equation will get Cp minus Cv. This is the difference in heat capacities, minus of T into dou V by dou T at constant pressure square into dou P by dou V at constant temperature. So this is an important equation in thermodynamic relations. And this is using this equation. This is the equation. Now look at this. We have some discussion on this equation. In this equation, look at here, dou V by dou T to the power 2. So this term dou E by dou t is always positive. So even if you have negative value for this, so the squaring the value will give a positive value. And dou P by dou V at constant temperature. So this is dou P by dou V for any substance is negative. So this value, pressure, volume, they have opposite relationship. When the pressure increases, volume will decrease. And when the volume increases, pressure will decrease. They have opposite relationship. And this term dou P by dou V is always negative. So negative, this is positive. And this is negative, always negative, and negative into negative will become positive. So Cp minus Cv is always positive. So whatever the number here on the right hand side, so this will be a positive quantity. So remember, this is positive because of the square value, and this is positive always. Pressure and volume, they have opposite relationship. So you have a negative sign here, so negative into negative, this will become plus some value. So this right hand side is always plus positive. So Cp minus Cv is always positive, therefore Cp is greater than Cv. So for any gas, the specific heat capacity at constant pressure is greater than heat capacity at the constant volume. This is the first conclusion. So for any gas, remember Cp is greater than Cv. And again, you take the second, the same equation again, Cp minus Cv equation. And the second discussion, when T tends to 0, when this T tends to 0, so right hand side becomes 0. So Cp tends to Cv, that is Cp equal to Cv at absolute zero value. What is absolute zero? 0 degree Kelvin. So this is what absolute zero, minus 273.15 Kelvin. So for zero, absolute zero, Cp equal to Cv for any gas. And the third discussion, when dou V by dou T equal to zero, dou V by dou T equal to zero, that is possible for water at 4 degree Celsius. Right, when the density is maximum or specific volume is minimum, then again Cp equal to Cv. So when dou V by dou T equal to 0, this is possible only for water at 4 degree Celsius, then again Cp equal to Cv. And another discussion, Cp minus Cv, you take the equation, write the equation, and for ideal gas, Pv equal to mRT. So dou V by dou T equal to minus mR by P, which is V by T, and dou P by dou V at temperature equal to minus mRT by V square. So Cp minus Cv equal to mR, or Cp minus Cv equal to R. So this is again derivation, Mayer's equation. This we already derived in the earlier discussion, we derived. So this is also another derivation which prove that Cp minus Cv equal to R. And the term, so beta, we define another term, volume expansivity, which is beta equal to 1 by V into dou V by dou T at constant pressure. Isothermal compressibility is another parameter, KT equal to minus 1 by V into dou V by dou P at constant temperature. And substituting, Cp minus Cv equal to TV V square, beta square by K into KT. So this is another derivation, Cp minus Cv equal to temperature, volume, beta square divided by KT. So KT is the isothermal compressibility. So this is another conclusion for Cp minus Cv. And ratio of heat capacities. For constant entropy, dS equal to 0, and TdS equations are simplified as, when dS equal to 0, this actually, when dS equal to 0, what will happen? This is first TdS equation, Cv dT into T into dou P by dou T at constant volume equal to 0, into dV, that becomes Cv dT equal to minus of T into dou P by dou T at constant volume dV. From the second TdS equation, second TdS equation Cp into dT minus T into dou V by dou T at constant pressure dP, and rearranging Cp dT equal to T into dou V by dou T at constant pressure dP. And this ratio Cp by Cv equal to the first term divided by the second term, will get a negative sign, right? Temperature is cancelled, dou V by dou T at constant pressure, dou P by dou V, dou P by dou V at constant entropy, and this becomes reciprocal, dou T by dou P at constant volume. Remember, so this first temperature is cancelled, I have a negative sign here, dou V by dou T written as it is, dou P by dou T, this is the denominator, taken to the numerator, this becomes dou T by dou P at constant volume, and this dou P by dou S at constant entropy, because the condition is constant entropy. So this is the term. And the Cp by Cv, so we have this equation. So dou P by dou V, third theorem. So dou P by dou V at constant temperature into dou V by dou T at constant pressure into dou T by dou P at constant volume equal to minus 1. So I take the second and third term in the left hand side. This is taken to the other side. So minus 1 divided by dou P by dou T at dou P by dou V at constant temperature. And comparing, so the Cp by Cv equal to dou P by dou V at constant entropy divided by dou P by dou V at constant temperature. And this is on, known as gamma, specific heat ratio. So Cp by Cv equal to gamma. So this is the specific heat ratio. And when gamma is greater than what? So when gamma is greater than what? Dou P by dou V at constant entropy is greater than dou P by dou V at constant temperature. What is dou P by dou V? The slope in the pressure volume diagram. So you look at the pressure volume diagram. Dou P by dou V at constant entropy. The slope of the pressure volume diagram for constant entropy, that is isentropic process. So constant entropy process. This is the slope of the this is what the slope of the PV line at for constant entropy process, and dou P by dou V for temperature, constant temperature, isothermal process. So this is isothermal process, this is entropy, isentropic process. So this is the slope of isentropic process, this is the slope of constant temperature process, isothermal process. So in the PV coordinate, for gamma is greater than 1, always gamma is greater than 1, because remember Cp is greater than Cv. So dou P by dou V, so the slope of the isentropic line is always greater than slope of the isothermal line. That indicates the work done for constant temperature process is less than work input for constant entropy process. So therefore the slope of isentropic line is greater than the slope of the isothermal line in the PV diagram. Also work done for isothermal compression process is less than work done for isentropic compression process. So work input, so this is the compression process, from 1 to 2 is the compression process. So the isentropic process, work compression is less. For isothermal process, work compression is lesser than the isentropic process. And for polytropic process, the n value is less than gamma and greater than 1. So the work done will be between these two values. So for isothermal compression, it requires minimum work. So when you compress the fluid, when you compress the gas, the work input for isothermal compression is minimum. That is theoretically, isothermal compression work is minimum. And the energy equation, we take the TD, we take the system DU, D equal to TdS minus PdV, first thermodynamic equation. So when the system undergoing infinitesimal reversible process between two equilibrium states, the change in internal energy is given by the first equation, DU equal to TdS minus PdV. And substituting the first TdS equation here, so DU equal to Cv dT plus T into dou P by dou T at constant volume dV minus PdV, and rearranging DU into Cv dT, right? So you take the dV as a common parameter, T dou P by dou T at constant volume minus P into dV. And if U equal to a function of temperature and volume, then dU equal to dou U by dou T at constant volume dT plus dou U by dou V at constant temperature dV equal to, this is the second equation. Now comparing this first and the second equation, then you will write dou U by dou V at constant temperature equal to T into dou P by dou T at constant volume minus pressure. So these two equations, the coefficient of dV, comparing the coefficient of dV, we can write as dou U by dou V at constant temperature equal to minus of dou P by dou V at constant volume equal to minus P. And this is known as energy equation. And points remember. So remember, as I told earlier in the previous lecture, there is no mathematical problem solving in the this module. And we have to derive only the equations. So the first module, the Maxwell's equations are important. First lecture, the Maxwell's equations are important. And in the second lecture, the first TdS equation and the second TdS equations are important. You should be familiar. You have to work on this, the derivation of the first TdS equation, the second TdS equation. And these are all the reference book I used for preparing the slides. You can also refer to it for additional information. And if you have any queries, you can write to me, to my mail ID, and you can also give the comments. I will improve. Thank you for watching. We will meet again.